Hello and welcome to the Nardo and Sid show. I'm Sids.
And I'm Nardo.
Alright.
Yeah.
So, did you hear about Uplay?
No.
And their PC downloading service?
Oh, did it get hacked or something?
Yeah. They disabled it because it got hacked and people were able to download games for free.
They hate that.
Right? Right? That's like... I wish I had known about this. I would have got some free games.
That's a bummer.
I'm pretty sure there's nothing they can do to get the games back or anything, but now, you know, it's all shut down now, and they're saying it'll be back up whenever we fix this problem.
They could invalidate the games, you know?
Yeah.
Potentially.
I'm not entirely sure how the whole system works. So I really don't know. But kind of sucks for them.
You know. New Xbox 720, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They're talking about it having a feature similar to Google TV.
Yeah.
So, it'll take over the TV and, I don't really know why.
Oh, all right.
Do you know what Google TV is?
Not really.
Hmm.
So, I'm assuming it lets you use Google on your TV. I have no idea.
Is it
I should
just
look
like,
into this, I guess.
I'm assuming it's like a basic browser
right.
for your TV.
I wonder if it works like the Bing browser on the Xbox.
I don't really know.
Or the search thing on the Xbox, which just like brings you to the stuff in your Xbox.
I don't know. Apparently Google TV is about watching stuff.
All right.
All your TV shows, when you want to watch them, something.
It's like streaming it from the internet, but on your TV.
Are they saying it's going to have, like, Netflix like the Xbox has?
Maybe that's what they're trying to say. I don't know.
I think they're going to make their own.
They're just going to make their own thing. Hmm. All right. Where you can stream videos.
They're also saying the Kinect 2.0 will be able to detect eye movement.
What?
Yeah.
I don't like that.
That's weird, right? Like, how much do you need to know?
It makes me think about, on Futurama, they were doing the testing for, like, what people like for TV shows, and they had, like, helmets on them. And it was like, you know, seeing how much they paid attention to this.
What they say here is that they could use eye movement to pause content when a user turns their head.
What?
How annoying would that be?
Oh, man. Right? That would be terribly annoying.
Like, I just turned my head to scratch it or something.
Right?
Pause.
Especially because a lot of times when I'm watching stuff, I'm doing something else at the same time, so I'm not always looking at the screen.
Yeah. I'll be playing games on one and watching a movie on the other.
Yeah. Just kind of look back and forth. So yeah, that would annoy the shit out of me. Oh, man.
That would most likely be an optional thing, I think.
Right. Yeah, I'm sure you'd be able to shut that off. But I wouldn't like it at all. I also heard that they're saying that the new Xbox is going to require an internet connection just to load up the game.
Yeah. I saw something about that.
That's a cheap move right there.
Mm.
I know plenty of people who still use their Xboxes not online.
Yeah.
So, they're screwed out of using this new one.
It makes me think of, when one of the recent Mortal Kombat games came out, And when I say recent, I mean the past few years.
Right.
Yeah. I bought the game, and I get home, and then they're like, oh, yeah, you have to pay to play multiplayer online.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. What?
It was such a dick move.
Also, didn't you have to, like, pay to get the new characters that came out? Yeah.
I ended up getting a season's pass.
Yeah.
Just but still, just like, oh, yeah, surprise.
Right, surprise, give us more money. See, with Borderlands, I knew it was coming.
Yeah.
And I expected it. So I was okay with it. But yeah, like on a Mortal Kombat game, that seems, I don't know, a little silly.
An add-on is different than just paying for the privilege of multiplayer.
Yeah, to just use it, yeah.
I bought Mortal Kombat to play alone.
Yeah, right. Which, yeah, I'm sure everybody wants to play Mortal Kombat by themselves.
And then the servers were bad, so it was always cutting off and just kicking you out of matches. Gotta pay for this.
Right, yeah, pay to have bad servers. Alright, sweet. Oh.
What?
I'm glad I didn't get that game then. Well, Nintendo confirmed that Splinter Cell Blacklist will be launched on the Wii U.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So, good for Wii U. They've been like, someone give us a game. Come on. Let us put it on the system. Everyone's like, no, I don't wanna. But August 20th, apparently.
I remember we had talked about Aliens Colonial Marines coming on the Wii U. And they canceled that.
Yep. They sure did.
That's like most games like passed on the Wii U.
Yeah.
And now like a big game says they're gonna, and they're like, well, we were gonna.
We were going to.
The whole controller pass.
Oh, yeah, no. Yeah, but Splinter Cell, that's a big name.
Yeah. I think the big problem about going different from all the other systems is exactly that. They don't want to do more work.
Right, yeah.
Like, this is so much more game they got to make for one console.
Yeah.
And they got their deadlines and stuff. That's why they're always cutting.
Right, always. And pushing games back further, even.
Oh, well.
Right? I have fun with the Wii U, but yeah, I just want to see more games with it, so. Hopefully. Some more companies decide to try it out.
Have you gotten any of the staple games, you know, like Mario, Zelda?
I have not.
No.
Okay. I haven't used it much because it's not mine.
Yeah.
So. I think the one I played was like Nintendo World or something.
Yeah.
Where you go play mini games that were based off all of, you know, original games.
I just, like, on every Nintendo system, I always enjoy the same group of games.
Right, yeah. Yeah, I would love to, like, play a full-on Zelda game for that system.
I think
that would be amazing.
When Metroid came out for GameCube.
Yep.
And it was, like, you know, the most amazing Metroid. You know what I mean? It went 3D and stuff.
Right, yeah.
It changed that game.
Right? I haven't played a Metroid game in a long time either.
Yeah.
And really, that just makes me want to play Smash Bros. Because I'm thinking of Samus.
How about Zelda?
Well, we can play this Zelda theme song that most people think is done by System of a Down, but apparently, according to all these articles I found on the internet, it's done by this group called Rabbit Joint.
Rabbit Joint?
Rabbit Joint.
Okay.
Right. I like it. So here it is. Zelda theme.
come to town. Come to save the Princess Zelda. Gone and poker away. Now the children don't play, but they will when Link saves the day. Hallelujah! Now Link, fill up your hearts so you can shoot your sword with power. And when you're feeling all down, the valley will come around. So you'll be brave and not a sissy coward. Now Link has saved the day.
I love that song.
Yeah.
It's terrific.
Almost everyone does.
Right? So thank you, Rabbit Joint. I'm sorry that you didn't get credit for this song.
But we're on your side now, so.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So. I don't know if they make any more music, but they should. More video game songs, please.
Yeah.
So, did you hear that EA got named the worst company in America by Consumerist?
Yeah, I had heard that in years past.
Yeah. Well, again.
That's a bummer.
2013.
Why did they even do that?
I don't know. Because, I guess?
It's like, who's the least successful actor of 2012? Why would you even...
They went against Bank of America. Like, they came in second, I guess. Bank of America.
Oh, man.
Right?
Yeah, but that's what I want in rougher shape than my video games, my money.
Yeah, the Bank of America. Oh, shit.
Like, way to live up to your name. Bank of America.
There was, a response from a representative that just says, we can do better. We will do better. She's like, yeah, we know we suck. We're sorry.
We're not the bank America deserves.
I don't even remember the last EA game that I played, honestly.
Hmm. I have this tendency to just not pay attention to
into
which
the
game makes a company.
Yeah.
You know.
Yep. So, the Zynga CEO is gonna get a dollar salary for 2013.
What, a dollar?
A single dollar.
Why?
Because they're doing terrible.
Jeez.
Let's see here. They had over $209 million loss. And there was a bunch of closures and layoffs.
Hmm.
But apparently, like, this guy and Steve Jobs get paid a dollar every year for
like,
this
company.
Like, why? Yeah, like, what is the point? I don't know, maybe for some, like, legal reason they have to be paid something, so they're just give me a dollar, I don't care.
Like, at that point, I'd rather you just give me something the value of a dollar that I want. You know, just give me a candy bar, a soda or something.
Right.
$8. Yeah, let me just put that in my wallet here.
$8.
And I assume that they, like, did they direct deposit?
Right?
There's no way to write a check.
Yeah, so you gotta come in and get your check. For $1.
save them up for 5 years, and then I can go to Subway.
Yeah. Woo. All
right, so.
Foot long.
I went to the EA Games website.
Uh-huh.
And I was looking, and they have a lot of popular games.
Yeah?
Such as Command & Conquer, Battlefield 4, Madden NFL 25, Army of Two.
Army of Two, that was the last EA game I played. The 40th
Star
day.
Star Wars The Old Republic. We nice. Played that.
We did. Played a lot of that.
Yeah.
But that's not doing good now either.
They make all the sports games that you can think of.
Yeah, I knew all the sports games, but I don't play sports games.
Yeah, but you know how many people
do?
It's
not my thing. A lot of people do. Apparently, worst company of the year.
It's crazy. I wonder if that's because they do stuff like make 8 golf games a year, you know?
Right.
And most of them do terrible or whatever. I don't know. I don't understand the business world. I don't try to.
It's not my thing. I just play the games.
Mm-hmm. So, SimCity is coming to Mac June 11th.
Sweet.
Yeah, if you have a Mac. I mean,
I'd say for anyone who has a Mac, which I do not.
They've also just re-enabled Cheetah Speed.
Cheetah Speed!
It was removed a month ago because their servers couldn't handle it.
Oh.
Like, they had to take out a bunch of unessential features, they called it, or non-critical.
Non-critical.
So they pulled Cheetah Speed, they pulled achievements, leaderboards.
Yep.
Just to keep their servers stable.
Alright, that makes sense.
Yep.
Good call.
But I guess they're building them back up because they got Cheetah Speed back.
Sweet.
But, you know, that's just the fastest time setting.
Right. Yeah, just makes everything go faster. Nice. Yeah, they seem to have a few server problems when the game first launched, but I mean, they've been right on top of trying to fix everything.
You know, since I got into computer gaming a few years ago, I've realized that's a computer thing.
What?
When they launch a new game, there's problems with the servers.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Every game I've gotten, it's always like that.
Yeah, every time. Because they're just... I don't know. No one ever seems ready for the amount of people that are trying to get onto that server at the same time.
There's just so many pieces to make this equation, right. You know?
Right, yeah.
It's way too many things working together for it to work easy.
Yeah. It's trying to give too much information and receive too much information from everywhere.
Yeah.
Well, this game Shadowrun.
Mm-hmm.
Shadowrun Returns, apparently, is the name of it, actually. But it will be released in June. This was a Kickstarter project.
Cool.
So, yeah. Pre-orders will be available on Steam April 29th. And you can pre-order the collector's edition for $75.
I think I will pass.
You sure? but you can do it. I just told you that you can.
I don't know if I have $75.
I do not at the moment. Get paid tomorrow. So, Skyrim is getting the 1.9 patch, which... apparently fixes a whole bunch of things. So, anyone who was waiting for that. Oh, there's also a new difficulty.
Hmm.
So that's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Upgraded skills that will allow further leveling.
That's cool.
That sounds cool.
I don't know about you, but I've been really enjoying the Borderlands update.
I have been, yeah.
I found some pretty cool guns so far already.
Nice. I really am not enjoying the enemies having health regeneration.
No, it's terrible.
Yeah, I hate it.
It's hard.
It does.
Anyway.
It's not like a slow health regen either.
No, it's quick.
So, yes, continue.
You've heard of that game Thief? It's coming out next year?
Yep.
The developer's goal was, I guess they did an interview, and yep. They're saying that they really will put it into the PC version.
Yep.
Like, not just make it a straight copy of the console game.
That'd be cool.
And, you know, it's kind of cool to me when they focus a little bit more on PC gaming.
Yeah.
I don't know, that might sound elitist or whatever.
Right, because you're a PC gamer. But, you know, whatever. I like it when they make things better for the console that I use.
I don't know, I think it's cool. It sounds negative when you repeat it back to me.
Yeah, well, when you say it like that, sounds bad. No, I think they should do that with, like, every console. They should make it, you know, more specific to the console.
It doesn't really say that they're... It kind of says they're doing that.
Yeah.
Not just that they're focusing on PC, but they're focusing on them independently.
All independently. I think all games should do that.
That is pretty cool.
Which would be cooler, like, for the Wii U, because... No one wants to make a game for it, apparently.
That's true. I've been looking forward to this game since I heard about it.
Yeah. Cool.
I like a stealth first-person shooter type game.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool. I'm definitely interested. So, do you know in China, you can pay women to play video games with you?
Hmm.
Right?
That's weird.
Yeah. Apparently they've had a thing over there for years where, like, you can pay, like, and bars and beer companies will, like, promote these girls, and then you can pay them to come get drunk with you. So now they're, like, bringing that into the video game world.
So really you're just hiring an escort.
Pretty much. Just come play video games with me. That's what our world has come to. Right? I mean...
I'm having trouble processing. Like...
This is in China, so, you know, they gotta be pretty good at video games, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that would be cool. Also, you know, they wear scantily clad clothing.
scant clothing.
Scant. Right?
It's just so weird.
I thought it was kind of weird, yeah.
I think about it, I'm like, well, it kind of sounds like a good time.
Yeah, doesn't it? That's what I'm saying, like, as long as they're good at video games, this is cool.
Or hot. I mean...
Right.
What would you get right now for a hot Asian chick to come play video games with you?
You know, whatever she wanted, probably.
Money!
I don't have any of that.
Oh, yeah.
We were just discussing this.
Right.
And yeah, if I was going to pay an Asian girl to come over to my house, I don't think it would be to play video games. Just saying.
Alright. How about another song?
Really good idea. This is a way old school song from a time that we would all probably rather forget, but I'm bringing it back up, so... This is Human Video Game by DJ Jazzy Jeff and
the Fresh Prince.
Will Smith, right? The Fresh Prince.
I was younger, I was into video games, trying to whatever, it didn't matter the name. Thousands of my dollars have been poured into all types of games, trying to get the high score. But now I think I have a favorite. It's me against an ape. He's got my girl, I've got to save her. Oh no, I feel an attack coming on. Yo, ready, Roxy, I wanna play a game of Donkey Kong. I have. I would feel the urge and I'd go stuck raving mad, breaking to the arcade, screaming and hollering, anticipating putting $25 in any machine who was out of control. I didn't need quarters, I brought $10 bankrolls, bags of quarters. I was insane, people thought that I worked there and asked me for change, but I would get defensive and yell, leave me alone, these are my quarters, stupid, go get your own. Dude walked away with just looking in his eyes like, oh man, I wonder what's wrong with that guy. I was addicted, a video burnout, and I would go crazy when the guy would have to turn out the lights at midnight. I'd fall on my knees and say, have a hard crowd, one more game, please. Some nights I might sleep on the subway or outside of the arcade till it opened up the next day. And when it opened at 9:45, it was the same old thing all over again. I was doing bad, my future was bleak. I'd rather play games than eat or sleep. Until one day, this guy came along. He didn't have a radio, but he was playing. I said, yo, what's that noise?
What noise? I don't know.
No, fool, what noise you was making there?
What, this?
Yeah, that was death, man. Where'd you learn to do that?
Man, I don't know. I guess I always knew that. I had this talent deep down inside. Hush, you want to hear some more, man?
Yeah.
Come on, let's take a ride.
He made sounds like I never heard before, and he still had more. Then he got me hyped when he played this incredible song, and I lost my mind when Ready C played Donkey Kong. Talking about.
Game over. Yo, Scrammy, why are you still standing there? The game is over.
Okay, so
there was a little bit of Batman news.
Yeah,
they announced the new Arkham game.
Awesome.
Batman Arkham Origins. Huh. Now it's not going to be Rocksteady making it. It's going to be Warner Brothers Games Montreal. All
right, so a whole new company.
But
well, different from the other one.
We're hoping they'll go the same way with it.
Right. Yeah.
This is out October 25th of this year.
Sweet. A nice Batman game in time for Halloween.
Yeah, and it's an origin story where he meets a lot of the enemies for the first time.
Nice.
And, like, Deathstroke comes to kill him, I mentioned.
Sweet. All right. Well, I guess that's all we have time for.
Cool. Cool.
So, bye.